In this presentation, we're going to take a look at the formatting of the unassigned categories and take a look at some alternatives for the formatting of the unassigned categories. Get ready, because here we go with Xero. Not-for-profit organization dashboard. We're going to be opening up our income statement worksheet, go into the accounting dropdown, go into the income statement worksheet. On the right-hand side where we have these unrestricted items or the unassigned items, I should say, not unrestricted. So we've categorized all these. Our worksheet works well, but we still have these items in unassigned and that looks a little bit funny. So in other words, if we look at this first item, we've got the unrestricted has nothing, restricted has that 204 in it, and that makes sense for the total. These three columns are correct. However, we still see that one, the 204, 160 over here, which is a little bit confusing. Why is it over there? Well, it's because it's part of a restricted category, and because we had two separate categories of restrictions, we didn't categorize it for the unrestricted category. So there's a couple different solutions you can do to solve this problem. It's not really a problem, but it's a little annoying to see this here. We'd like to see basically these two columns zeroed out, and that would indicate that we had assigned everything. So one way you could fix this is instead of having two separate class categories here, we could have put everything, whether it be unrestricted or restricted, in one class category, and therefore have one column, and then just simply choose the proper categorization every time we do a data input form. And so we wouldn't have two unassigned columns here. We couldn't, because there's only be one column of assigned. I'll show you that more detail in a second. Or we can basically, every time we enter a transaction that doesn't relate to one of these categories, we make a new category that just says, you know, doesn't apply here, NA or something like that, non-applicable. So that's what we'll do. So let's take a look at how this would look. And again, just note that this worksheet is fine. You're fine with this worksheet. We wouldn't really have to do this, but this is just to make it a little bit cleaner in terms of the worksheet settings. So you could do it going forward. Also note that you could do this as you go. We're going to go in and do it kind of retroactively, but you could do the data input as you go in this type of format as well. So I'm going to right-click on the tab up top. I'm going to duplicate this tab. I'm going to go back to the tab to the left. And then I'm going to go up top and we're going to go into our settings. So I'm going to go into the not-for-profit drop-down. We're going to go into the settings. So we'll take a look at these settings. And then we want to go into the advanced settings. So I'm going to go down to the bottom to looking for advanced settings. And I'm going to click on it because we are indeed looking for the advanced settings. And that's where they are. So then we're going to go down here and say we want to go to the category tracking or tracking categories. Tracking categories is what we want. And here's what I mean by this. We have two separate sections here. So we have two kind of categories and then subcategories or category options within them. So we could just make one category, which is basically everything. We just call it, you know, this is our category thing. And then put all the options down below in it. And that means we'll only have one column. We won't have two separate columns in our data input forms. And we just gotta make sure that we select the right ones for the unrestricted categories and the restricted. That might make it a little bit more confusing when we allocate the items in our data input form rather than having two separate columns, but that could lessen, you know, the form, the room on the data input form, and that's one option we could use to make it possibly easier to make our reports. The other thing we could do is we can have two items as we do here, and then I'm going to add another category and just call it NA or not applicable or something like that. Let's say NA, not applicable. And I'll say not applicable and make sure I say this is for the unrestricted so that it's distinct from the not applicable. I'm going to put over here the restricted item. So I'm going to then say save that. Now every time we input something and there's not a category for unrestricted, we'll go to NA not applicable. So then I'm going to go back to the restricted side and I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to say, all right, every time we don't have something in here, I'm not going to just leave it blank. I'm going to add another category. And I'm going to say NA for not applicable. Not applicable for the restricted items. And then say OK. So now when we do the data input, we're going to do it retroactively, but you could do this as you go. I'm going to go back to the income worksheet. I mean, I'm going to go into each of these unrestricted items, and I'm just going to assign them to an NA category. It's not applicable. So to do that, I'm going to go up top. I'm going to right-click. And I'm going to duplicate the tab. Then I'm going to pull the tab from the left to the right. The reason I keep doing that is because that makes it so I have a separate tab, and then I can go back to this report as I make changes on this one by drilling into it, and this one's already been populated. I don't have to wait for it to populate. Then I'm going to go into the 204-160. So we're going to go into the 204-160 here. And we have two things in it. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to right click on the tab up top. I'm going to duplicate the tab. I'm going to pull the tab from the left to the right. So again, I can make adjustments on this tab. And then this tab's the same one. I can go back and do it again on that tab. So I'm going to go into the 108 here. So we're going to go into the 108 and drill down on this item. Then I'm going to edit this item. So I'm going to edit it. And then on the unrestricted, instead of leaving it blank, because it doesn't apply, there is no unrestricted item here. So instead of leaving it blank, which means it's going to populate in that unrestricted category, I'm going to say I want to just put it into NA, not applicable. So not applicable. And then I'm going to update that. And then hopefully it'll turn green. So hopefully we'll have a green item up top, or it says, I think it's good. I think it's okay. So I'm going to check it out now. I'm going to close this out. And then I'm going to update this report, and one of these should go away. So I'm going to update this report, and one of these should disappear. So there we have it. Now I'm going to click the other one. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to click on this one. This is going to be the other item that was in that unrestricted category. I'm going to edit this. I'm going to go to the option up top. I'm going to edit it. And note, again, I'm doing this retroactively. This is not something you have to wait till the end to do. Anytime it's not applicable to one of these categories, you could go in here and say NA basically as you go, as you do the data input. And so then I'll say update. So there we have that. And so then we update that report. And then I'm going to close this back out. That'll take me back to my income statement worksheet, which I will now update. And now we have removed it. I'd like to see these dashes over here, not these things to be empty. And then I'm going to go into the next one. I'm going to do the same thing. So we're going to say the 237. Go into each of these. So I'm going to right click on it again. I'm going to right click up top so we can drill down on these. I'm going to say we want to duplicate the tab. I'm going to pull the tab from the left to the right. These two are the same, but this one's going to be the one it's already populated and I can drill down on it. So now we're going to drill down on it and make the changes in this tab. So we're going to enter into edit it. So I'm going to say options. We're going to say that we want to edit the transaction. And then within the transaction, I'm going to just say that we're going to put this item to NA for the restricted side this time because it's in unrestricted. So for the restricted side, not applicable. I'm going to update this then again. Update this. Looks good. Then I'm going to close this back out and go back to the prior tab. So now I'm going to update this tab. One should disappear now. Updating this tab. One disappears. I'm going to do the next one. Actually, I shouldn't. I should go back. I'm going to go back and I'm going to duplicate the tab again. So duplicate the tab. Duplicate the tab. I'm going to pull the tab from the left to the right. And then I'm going to go into that 189.7, 189.7 top. We're going to say that we want to edit the transaction, editing the transaction. I'm going to say this restricted column should now be not assigned, not NA. And so then I'm going to say update that one. So there we have that. And that looks good. So I'm going to close this back out. And then in this report, we should have assigned one out now. So I'm going to update it and it should then repopulate for us. So I'm going to update that and then I'll go into the next one. There's only one left, so I'm just going to go right into this one. And then we're going to go to the options up top. We're going to edit this transaction, editing the transaction. And then I'm going to say on the restricted side, I'm going to say NA. So I'm going to go, this is NA, and then update that one. So we'll update that and that'll take us back to our report. So that looks good. So I'm going to close this back out and then go back to our worksheet, which has gone away somehow. Accounting. I'm on the income statement worksheet. It's gone. I'm just going to keep on going. Here's this one is unassigned here. So note that these two columns should tie out to this column. That's how you know that things are working out. And what we might want to have here is another column as well that calculates this by adding these two columns up, and that way we can just easily look at those two columns. But in any case, I'll go into this one now, and we're going to say that we'll change this one. So we'll go in here, just one item. So I'm going to go into that one item and restricted here. We're going to say, I have to edit it. Options, we'll edit the transactions, and then I can go into that item. We're going to go into the unrestricted item and put NA in A. So there we have it. And then let's update that. So we'll update this one. And so once again, I haven't been duplicating my tabs again. So I'm going to have to go to the accounting and go to my income statement worksheet again. So let's open up the income statement worksheet. Keep going. This time I'm going to right click on this tab up top. I'm going to duplicate this tab. So we're going to have another tab. This is the way I should have been doing it the whole time here. Sign these out. So these are all done below. And once we're done, we'll also add another total column. So be ready to do that. I think that's a useful thing on the worksheet as well. So then we'll go to the restricted. So this item, we're going to do the same process here. So we'll go into that one item in it. So let's just go into that item. Restricted one below. This one is on both sides where we have a portion of it that's not assigned to go up top and edit it. And so this one's unassigned on this side. And so I'm going to say NA here, NA there, and then this one's unassigned on this side, so I'm going to say NA here, and then post that one. So notice we're just filling every time there's a blank on the one of the restricted categories, we're filling it in. Closing this one back out, we're going to update this report. So there we have that, and then let's do this. So that took care of both of those. So now these are all applied out. Now we still have all these items in the unrestricted column for all the expense items. I won't go through all of them, but just note that on every expense item, let's not do depreciation because it's a journal entry. Let's do one that's not a journal entry. So I'll go back on over and say, let's say like the rent, if we went into the rent, when you do the data input, you don't have to wait till the end like we did before. What you want is it for to be possibly leaving it blank for the unrestricted item. And then on the restricted ones, you can then, so I'll go into any one of these, will go into the same transaction because we applied it out to four places here. So on all the restricted, when you're doing the data input, you could leave the unrestricted basically blank and then apply it out as we did at the end. And that's what should properly show up in unrestricted so that you can then go back in and apply it out. The restricted items, then you could put all them as you do the data input just to NA. And so I have to hit the options to do that. So we'll go to options and we're going to go to edit the transactions. So this you can do as you do the data input so that it doesn't show up in the restricted. And as we then adjust it, we'll in the restricted area, we'll say NA, not applicable, and then NA, not applicable, and then NA not applicable and NA not applicable. And so then we'll save and update that. And once again, I didn't copy the report, so I'll go back into it again. I'll go to the accounting drop down. We'll go to the income statement worksheet, assign that one out. So at the end of the day, these two unassigned should be kind of a check figure to tell you that they should all be zero and everything should be assigned. And then these two columns should tie out. So like I say, if you see these things that you leave it the way we had it before, it's still fine because you can tell that this one's unassigned for the restricted because it was in unrestricted. That's why it's unassigned for the restricted side. So that's fine. It's just cleaner if you can make them all zeros because these should be a check figure. And then we might want to have another total column that sums up these totals two separate ways for our worksheet, not for our external reports, but our worksheet. And that way it's kind of a double check for us. So let's check that out. I can edit this worksheet here and say, let's say we add another column. I'm gonna hold down control, scroll down just a bit to, let's go to the 100%. This total column, notice it's total by category. So let's rename it total by category. And then let's add another one. Let's add another line and let's make this one a formula. So I'm going to make this one a formula and I'm going to say I want to make this the unrestricted plus the restricted. Unrestricted plus the restricted. And this one's over to the right. We can't see it. If I double click on it, this is going to be total by formula. Total by formula. And then I'm going to drag these two totals to be next to each other. I'm going to grab that blue item, drag it to the left. And so now they're side by side. And this will give us for our worksheet a double check on our calculation. This one's calculating one way, not adding these two up, but just assigning the categories, which should be the same. And then these two are adding the two up, and those two should be, you know, the same. And you even could have another column which would take the difference between these two items, which should be zero, right? And that would mean that these items over here, these three columns would be our check figure, which should be zero at the end of the day. So for example, you could take another column, and this is really neat that you could do this with zero, and you can say, okay, I wanna have another formula, and I'm just gonna call this our check number, and the check number should be the total by category minus the total by formula. And this, right, and then this, if I double click on the name, this is gonna be check numbers. And that should be zero, and I'm gonna then pull this over next to the total columns. And so now these three columns should all be zero at the end of the day, in essence. Those are our check figures at the end of the day. So we're gonna say done, and then pull up our worksheet. Column is zero over here, and this column is checking these two numbers. So these two columns are the same. They're calculating different ways. This one's with a formula. This one's with a category. It's really nice to have the category here because it also allows you to drill down on it. So this one allows you to drill down on it. This one gives you a double check. This one might be redundant. You might not need that because you could see these two tie out. But if you have a column of zeros, it's just so easy to see those zeros. And this report's not too big, that's not too bad to be able to see. So these last three columns, then if we input everything, you know, properly in the new system we set up with these unassigned, means that these should all be zeros. And again, these, we know why these are not. But, you know, if we did it that way, we can then see all these are zeros. Not a problem that these are here. You don't have to do that. But like I said, it could be a cleaner report, and you can kind of double check on this. And then you could take this report and make our final reports, which will basically be this report with just these first three columns. And I can just make another report. This is my internal worksheet that helps me to have my check figures in it. Then we can have an external report, which is the one that, of course, we would be providing to whoever needs it, the board or whatever, with minor adjustments we might make within Excel. However, a lot of the stuff we can do is actually in the system with this formatting of the reports.